Okay, I have a few tape recorders to show you here. First is this Califone 3430AV. Now I have a smaller Califone that I showed a while back in a couple videos. This one is bigger. It's a more heavy-duty model. It has a three-prong power cord. And it's an AV model, so they give you a bunch of headphone outputs on the back there. And also I have this Lafayette tape recorder. It's a very basic old-fashioned model for an analog meter and manual level control on the volume control. And there's no built-in microphone. You have to use external. I've been working on it, trying to get it going. When I first got it, it would record, but playback was just hissing and crackling. And I opened it up and vacuumed it out, all the dust, and it would play, but very weakly. And then I tried the WD-40 in the controls. Now they're less scratchy, but it still doesn't play very strong, and there's some motor boating when you move it these in certain positions, so it might have bad capacitors. There are a bunch of electrolytics in there. Yeah, so one belt is still good. It's a little loose, but it rewinds and fast forwards fine. And there's the circuit board and the two controls I sprayed. Well, actually I just used an eyedropper of WD-40, and the little speaker. It could be bigger, but it's a Pioneer brand speaker, so it's a name brand speaker, at least they used. Says Lafayette Radio Electronics Corp. Deluxe Cassette Recorder Model RK86A, made in Japan. It has earphone, aux input, microphone and remote. And I'll try to get it going a little bit here with this sample tape I recorded. This neat looking, very colorful CVS cassette. See, there's the motor boating.
Testing, testing the Lafayette cassette recorder with manual level control. Okay, now I have the level control all the way up. I'm holding the microphone at quite a distance, and the meter is still fluctuating all the way to the maximum. So now I'll turn it down to a lower level. Now I'm speaking right up to the microphone. Let's see if the tone control has any effect while recording. Turn it down.
See, you can barely, just barely able to hear it. So I'll give you a better example. I put the same tape in the Califone here so you can hear it louder.
Now, tone control is all the way down. Turning it back up, tone control is at maximum. Let's see how this comes out. This machine records, but it does not play. When you try to play, it just makes some squealing and crackling noises. So hopefully it's just a dirty record play switch or something else simple, because it appears to be a very old and high quality cassette player recorder, maybe early to mid 70s, by Lafayette, made in Japan. I'm also pretty sure that it's AC bias recording. Okay, I just opened it up and vacuumed it all out, and now it is playing, but the sound is very weak, even with the volume all the way up. I think part of the problem might be that the volume and tone controls are extremely scratchy, so I'm going to try the WD-40 trick and see if that improves the playback volume and gets rid of the scratchiness. So here we go.
I'll give you a little sample of recording on the Lafayette. Plug in the microphone here. Okay, I noticed the The remote switch also, it won't even let you rewind if you have the switch off. You have to turn the switch on before it can move the motor at anything you're doing. And also, the flash forward button doesn't stay on. You have to hold it. So let's hit record here, turn the level all the way up. And you have to push both buttons to get to record. Now it should be recording. See, it's moving, and the thing is going back and forth with my voice. So let's see how this comes out. I'll try to play on the Lafayette, and if that doesn't sound good, I'll put it in the Califone so you can hear how it really sounds. It's probably overdriving the tape. Look at it, it's maxing out when I talk. In fact, I'll talk at arm's length here, and you can see it's still wiggling back and forth quite a bit. So, see, it doesn't rewind unless I turn on the switch.
See, it's moving, and the thing is going back and forth with my voice.
Alright, it did come out.
Playback.
Somewhere there should be my recording.
Okay. Now it should be recording.
There it goes.
See, it's moving, and the thing is going back and forth with my voice. So, let's see how this comes out. I'll try to play on the Lafayette, and if that doesn't sound good, I'll put it in the Califone so you can hear how it really sounds. It's probably overdriving the tape. Look at it. It's maxing out. When I talk, in fact, I talk at arm's length here, and you can see it's still wiggling back and forth quite a bit.
So, you know, it's recording fine, just need some work to get the playback going. It's probably bad capacitors. There's a whole bunch of electrolytics in there, which is not going to be a fun job to replace them all, but, it's a high-quality machine, you know, early 70s, probably, by Lafayette. So, I hope you liked the video, also including this Califone. Okay. Two more things of note about these tape recorders. This one, when I first got it, all the protective film was still on these decals here. So I left this one on so I can peel it off on camera here. Some people, I guess, never take these off in all the years they own this kind of equipment. Because I never seen an owner's manual for anything that says, peel this thing off. So people just don't know and they leave it on. And it usually gets all crinkly and it just doesn't look good. So, there you go. Don't forget to remove the protective film off of the things. Or, on the other hand, hope that the previous owner of what you get never did that. So you can peel it off and get a brand new looking decal. And also on this one, instead of eject, it says cassette up. First time I've seen that on any kind of a tape recorder, and obviously it's not a very soft eject at all. Even this one. Just, I guess, these companies didn't believe in soft eject. Either Califone or Lafayette. Let's see what model this thing is. Califone International. Chatsworth, California. That's where they're based. Made in China. And it shows, because this is not as high quality as my smaller Califone, which is from 1977, I think. This one, the controls just feel more cheap. The buttons feel more plasticky. And it just, you know, they get this flimsy little plastic handle, so obviously even Califone was not immune to the trend of getting cheaper and cheaper as the years goes by, as compared to solid metal construction like this. I mean, it's very, very high quality machine. Just needs some work. So, there you go. Two tape recorders.